Life Before Us, a Canadian docu-fiction on the lives of the Dunbar family during the Second World War, written by Rupert Payne and Johnny Connoxter, narrated by Rob Stevens. Episode 2. Now, the prime suspect in the murder of Cadet Dunbar was the Romanian. This simple Ed, low-level thug, had spent time in Alcatraz before escaping to Canada. The word on the street is that the Romanian had drained the gas on Cadet Dunbar's trainer in retaliation for unpaid prostitute and gambling debts. Now, Cadet Dunbar was no choir boy and liked to party hard. He was known to take big losses betting on the pony races. Our war hero was also very sweet on one painted lady called Slutsy O'Connor, who was part of the Romanian stable of call girls. Cadet Dunbar always paid his debts, so his demise was not likely over money, but over the affections of a girl. The Dunbar family lived at 10 Coxwell Avenue in Toronto. James Dunbar was the head of the household. Mr. Dunbar supported his family as a milkman for the Bell's Dairy Company, and it was James who serviced the Beaches area community with his familiar big red milk truck. The highlight of the Dunbar family of the week were Sunday dinners. Friends and relatives would often attend and post for pictures and partake in the friendly game of Crocono, a board game which needed some skill for taking out the opponents with a flick of a middle finger against a wooden puck. The family dog Poker would entertain the little children for hours. Poker would do his amazing dog tricks for scraps from the lavish dinners prepared by Aunt Mabel and Mother Hazel. That concludes episode 2 of Life Before Us.